Citizen Summit is nice. It's necessary. We can see all the different areas of the city, different things that we need to improve.
I think it's fantastic. I lived here for almost 25 years, and this is great.
We can give our opinions in terms of what we think will make our city a better place, not only to live, but to be entertained and to have fun.
The Citizen Summit gives us that next level of where we get more specific feedback. Residents get to tell us more specifically what they would like to see in their city.
I imagine it's going to be a city that's going to be well welcome for our children in the future and for new businesses to grow.
A place for events. More things for people to do so that kids and families don't want to move from here when they grow up, to stay close to home and to be a community.
When the citizens give their opinions about what they want to see in the park, they kind of have a connection with it where they were part of the process. So they are happy that we're building what they want to see.
We voted on the zip line and like obstacle course because that would be really cool. Because we've been to one and it was so much fun. We had so much fun as a family.
It's always interesting to get some feedback from the citizens. You go in thinking that residents maybe want more BMX bikes. What we're hearing today is ropes course and, you know, different. So we're getting different feedback than maybe what we assumed, which is why it really helps us get better.
We got input from the residents of the types of industries they'd like to see either expand or come to Port St. Lucie, and then also the types of restaurants and retailers.
We're one of the biggest cities in Florida, but we're not really represented in terms of the jobs and the pay and the entertainment. And so that's the area that excites me, is let's get people to start to come to Port St. Lucie for events.
The number one thing so far has been concerts. Bigger concerts, and we're listening to them, we're delivering them to the community, and so we're just proud to be able to do that and listen to the people and what they really want to see. It's their event center, and we want to bring to them what they truly want to see here and support.
Just the fact that there's growth and that the city leaders are trying to cope with the amount of growth that we have in a responsible way, I think they're doing a good job.
I think the police department, law enforcement has a huge deal to do with it, family oriented, but I think it's the people that kind of run this city as far as keeping it intact, keeping it family-oriented, keeping it safe.
Law enforcement's been going through a crisis over the last several years, and it was actually studied, and what they found out was most agencies hadn't built relationships with their community. So we've been working on that for many years, and this is a great opportunity because they're here for many reasons, not just to talk to the police.
Not only are we getting input, but they're learning about the different departments. Some people may not have heard Keep Port St. Lucie Beautiful per se. They may have heard about the Adopt-A-Street, or they may know neighborhood services. So they're learning about all of the departments and how we're all together making our city great.
As we're growing over the next few years, we have big ideas, and we want to make sure that we're giving the people their dreams, that we have the opportunity to grow in the areas they want to grow, show restraint in the areas that they want us to hold back, and really have a chance to become the Port St. Lucie that people want to see.